Okay. Yeah.
Sup, Blake, Sid Kraken here. And for today's video, we do have a quiz video. I know, yes, quiz videos, I understand. But I actually really do enjoy making these videos. Believe it or not, I actually really do enjoy these videos. Before we even get into this, I just want to say real quick, especially from yesterday's skit that I did, if you haven't checked that out, there should be a link somewhere up here, maybe like an info card or something. Feel free to check it out. You know, it's a really awesome little skit that I did. It just pokes a little bit of fun at what's currently going on with YouTube. I know a ton of people are saying that it definitely left off on a cliffhanger, which is not exactly what I wanted, but I thought it would have been perfect to end it there. So that's kind of interesting. You know, I didn't know what's got off that cliffhanger there. I was like, that was crazy. That was so cool. We're going to get into this video. Let's get right into it. Now, specifically for this quiz video, I'm going to be doing which one of the five types of powers do you possess? I felt like this would have been a really interesting quiz, not only because it kind of like takes a little bit off of the normal personality quizzes. I know a lot of people do enjoy these videos because for the fact of you get to learn more about the person who is making the content, i.e. like, you know, a lot of different type of YouTubers. For me, I enjoy these because you kind of get like a little bit more of like a personal glimpse into, I guess, me, into like me as a person by my personality. And it's really cool. I really do enjoy this. So, this is gonna be fun. Is it important for you to be popular? I guess I say sometimes. I'm not really too much on keening all the time to be popular, but I sometimes do tend to think about it, you know, how cool it would be to be like, hey, you know, this person's popular. That is just me. Sometimes I think about that. So yeah, sometimes. I am more methodical and precise, or spontaneous and indistinctive. I would have to say spontaneous and indistinctive because I like to kind of go with the flow. I'm the type of person, I like to go with the flow. That is absolutely my sort of deal, and I just like, you know, kind of being that way. You never know what kind of end result you're gonna get from whatever it is that I'm working on, from being spontaneous and indistinctive. Because then if people know more about what you're doing, then it's like, hey, where's the fun in that? I like the secrecy in it all. Which one of these character traits is likely to lead to your success? Ooh, we got raw intelligence, education, charisma, resources, fearlessness, originality, endurance, or other. Ooh, I feel like which one of these character traits would lead to my success? I would have to say my charisma. Now, for me, I kind of don't know what charisma is. I'm being 100% honest here, so I'm going to have to Google search charisma. Charisma. Freak. A compelling attractiveness or charm that can inspire devotion to others. Okay, there you go. That's pretty much it. That's what I would say is my charisma. I totally feel like my charisma, specifically by my character, is very energetic. I like to be positive as much as I can. Even though I understand everyone has their good and bad days, I always like to kind of like repel the bad days with something at least good to put me in a better mood than I actually was. Because, you know, I don't want to get stuck in a terrible mood and then you don't feel like doing anything and you don't feel like being inspired and being yourself and, you know, me making a video. You know, I don't like having those days. Those days for me are really not the greatest. So I would have to say my charisma would lead to my success, because for me personally, for a lot of people who know me, I'm very easygoing. I'm very, I guess to say, not in a cocky sense, but I'm very interesting in the way that I present myself and how the way I love to present myself. It's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. I think charisma's the one. Do you seek out positions of leadership? I guess I would say no, but it happens anyways. A reason being is there is some certain situations where I feel, for me personally, as I kind of sometimes don't feel exactly like a leader in certain situations. Other times, yes, I do, because I like the idea of guiding people into the right direction for what they want to do as a team. And that definitely does help at times, but sometimes when I don't really necessarily want that leadership role, it just kind of like leads in a little bit. I guess that's how to describe it. I don't know. It's like weird. I mean, I don't know. It's just, it's really weird. I guess, you know, that's fine. It's just no, but it happens anyway. It just happens anyway. You know, it happens anyway. Do you believe in luck? Are you kidding me? Yes, I do. I believe in luck. I'm I'm born in the month of St. Paddy's Day. Are you kidding me? I'm literally luck. My aim isn't lucky, but me as a person, yes, I feel lucky. I feel lucky, okay? I feel lucky that I'm able to even do this and even do videos like this all the time. So do I believe in luck? Yes, I do. A lot of the time. I believe it. I praise it. It is me. It is me. It describes me. Luck. How ambitious are you? Ooh, you're really... Boy. I'm about to gun you. What do you mean, how ambitious are you? Very, very ambitious. Very ambitious, because I feel like I have a mission. And that mission I've described millions of times over, so it makes it very interesting to keep it secret, because then people get to see, hey, this is the actual mission. Excuse me. Which one of these people is the most influential? Oh my God, they have Donald Trump on here. Okay, I understand, because he is a billionaire, and of course he is the president of the United States. That is cool, but in other words, I'm sorry. I can't. Dude, Kim Jong-un is in here. Bill Nye, Martin Scorsese, Barack Obama, or Queen Elizabeth. I would have to say Queen Elizabeth, because I've watched The Crown on Netflix, which is basically a story about her when she was younger. And to be honest, that is the realest story I've ever heard or seen in my life. Queen Elizabeth didn't want to be the queen. Her father died, and she was the only one in the family that got handed down the crown. So basically, she got handed down the biggest, like, sort of important role. And for her to, like, learn about what she had to do and stuff like that, especially, like, within the crown of the series itself, it is so insane how much stuff has happened. So I would say Queen Elizabeth II, for sure. Which one of these do you have no patience for? I have no patience. Ooh, this is kind of hard, because there's hypocrisy, laziness, stupidity, drama, complainers, and boredom. I would have to say I have no patience for stupidity. Drama is most likely my top, but, I would have to say stupidity, because stupidity, it's just common sense at certain times. You know, you gotta learn from the mistakes. You can't repeat them, otherwise you're just not learning the lesson at all, I guess to say. That's something completely different. I don't know. Anyways, that will have to be it. No patience for stupidity. Are you more optimistic or pessimistic? I'm more optimistic than I am pessimistic. I don't like to be pessimistic at all, because I don't like it. All right, so here we go. This is it. The power. Bring it on to me. What is my power? You are powerful because you were born to be powerful. Type 1, legitimate power. All right, let's see what this actually says in all together. You have what social psychologists call legitimate power. People follow you because they believe that you are entitled to your position. How you rose to that position of power is irrelevant to them. It could be because you were born into an influential family or because you were appointed by someone. Either way, your authority is seen as absolute and unquestionable. Use your power for good, and you can create real change in the world. Is this totally you? Tell us and leave it in the comments. Okay, I think that was pretty much it for my thing. So as from this, I am born with a legitimate power that a lot of people follow me because they feel that I am entitled to my position. And, you know, specifically with what I do on here on YouTube and streaming, a lot of people like of what kind of type of energy I have and what kind of, I guess to say, personality that I have as well too. And I think it definitely does fit when it comes to this sort of situation. I really do enjoy how I present myself, even online too. I really do enjoy it. So of course, if you guys did enjoy, feel free to infect that thumbs up button. It is much appreciated, and it helps out the channel to determine what you guys really do enjoy, so I can do more of those type of videos, you know, from time to time, and all the other good stuff that definitely does matter. So yes, I will be leaving a link to this specific quiz down below, and leave your comments to actually tell me what kind of power do you have. Do you have a legitimate power? Do you have some sort of weird extraterrestrial power? Do you have some sort of uninteresting power? Let me know in the comment section down below, and I shall see you guys next time.